Namaskar. For the last several years, we have seen that research and innovation are major factors when it comes to the ranking of universities. That's because universities are the breeding grounds of innovation and discovering new things. Promoting funding research, startups, innovation activities has become an inherent part of the academic and research system. Today, we have Dr. E. Muthukumaran, Assistant Professor, Electronics and Communication Engineering from DBRED, to speak on the topic Research, Innovation and Ranking. He has completed UG, PG and PhD in ECE from Anna University, Chennai. Having 16 years of academic and research experience, he has published over 20 papers in reputed national and international journals. He has completed various major research projects funded by DST, DBT, Ministry of Food Processing Industries, and other sponsored programs funded by METI, DRDO, Intel, and EDI. He is active member of various professional bodies like IETE, BMESI, and ECI. Dr. E. Muthukumaran.
Very good morning to everyone. I thank the management for supporting and giving such kind of awareness program to the participants. And I thank Alka Madam. I thank the coordinators for arranging this program. So today we'll discuss the important key factors which was highlighted in New Education Policy 2020 in terms of research, innovation, and ranking. If we notice for the past 10 years, the past decade, India has showing a progress in terms of quality as well as in terms of quantity of research. At present, India ranks third in global level for its total research output. It becomes a very significant change in terms of research and output. When compared with three factors, three aspects, education, knowledge generation through research and development, and innovation are the three important key factors of academic, India has shown the progress in terms of first two, that is in education we have achieved a lot. The percentage of people who enroll for education, higher education, has significantly improved. Similarly, when you look in terms of research and development, in past decade if you notice, the growth in research and development also significantly improved in terms of publications, in terms of ranking, QS ranking. But the research indicates that India lacks in innovation. So this is because one of the prime factor that most of the Indian researchers follows the Western. If we ask any people to start the research, they start with the problems which is taken from the other peoples. Or they've taken others as their benchmark, other countries, Western countries. So that is one of the very important drawback which is noticed in terms of lacking innovation in India. So to eradicate such thing, Government of India through National Education Policy given more weightage for innovation. Government expects the students to come out with a new idea, creative and logical thinking, which solves the local problem, community problem, social problem, which is even around them. So this NEP 2020 highlights you might have discussed for the past few days in this program. So we are aware that new education policy has played a significant role on there is no language barrier hereafter. So from the fifth standard onward, the students can take the vocational training programs. They can go for multidisciplinary systems. So all these things you might have listened for the past few days. There are very important key factor here in new education policy is the government wants us utilize the children's creativity as well as the thinking capability, and it has to be utilized by the society. That is one of the very important key factor in this new education policy 2020. It promotes the research. As per NEP 2020, it promotes the outstanding research in terms of education, because government believes that education, quality of education will improve only by research. So they want to utilize, they want to cater the students who are having the critical thinking, who are having innovative knowledge, so which has to be utilized. So the policy gives a way to the children how to utilize those logical and creative thinking. The very important factor which we are discussing, how to promote this innovation, critical thinking and creativity. Why? Because the students are, we know that students are more intelligent than us, that we should accept. Because when you see our small children in our home, they used to think beyond our knowledge also sometimes. So we will find wonders when they ask some questions. So it means that the creativity is already in present with them. Now we have to come out with a solution which would bring out the innovative ideas and creativity of such kind of students. And not only bringing out the ideas, we have to make a policy, we have to make a way in such a way that the idea has to be converted into real things, either in terms of products or either in terms of research. It has to reach the objective as a whole. So based on this, under NEP 2020, it is proposed that lot of project clubs will be encouraged to support the students at all level of schools. Not necessary, because at present educational system, they will follow the systematic procedure, which may not have a way for them to expose their creativity or logical thinking. But as per NEP 2020, even they can take vocational training programs. Even the college students can study, because in multidisciplinary, they can study their multidisciplinary courses. For example, an engineering student will study a few parts of arts and science, so that it can be combined together and a new innovative idea will be exposed from that particular concept. So project-based clubs are one of the very important factor which was proposed in NEP 2020. And apart from that, use of technology for to increase the talented and gifted students, properly it has to be utilized. So based on which, government has come to a conclusion, all the academic institution will be combined together, and which is going to be formed as a multidisciplinary education and research in universities, shortly called as MERUS, MERUS. So it is going to be at par with IITs, NITs, IIMs, a National Institute of Importance, and it is going to be act as the model for multidisciplinary education as a global standard, at par with the global standard. Similarly, there are at present, there are different funding agencies are there in India, like DST, DBT, DRDO, Ministry of Food Processing Industry, Agriculture Research. So there are various funding agencies based on the domain. There are various funding agencies are there. But as per NEP 2020, now government has proposed a new concept of National Research Foundation, NRF. So hereafter, NRF is going to be the sole funding agency for all kind of research, which is going to support you the multidisciplinary research and innovative activities. So as per the National Research Foundation proposed by NEP 2020, we'll review the proposal provided by the students or faculty or any members having a critical idea which is going to solve the community problem, is going to be funded by NRF. So as I told you already, research in arts and science, humanities is very important, because the country's identity our culture is very important, our upliftment, spiritual, intellectual property, everything is going to be unique and it differs from country to country. So all this have a strong impact on their arts and culture. So government propose this arts and humanities has to be linked. The research in arts and humanities should be combined with the innovation in science and engineering, social science, so that it could solve the community problems. And NRF, when you take this NRF, National Research Foundation, any outstanding research by any of the people from any part of the country is going to be supported by Government of India. Previously, it was an assumption that only the reputed institution can get the fundings, maximum fundings. But as per NEP 2020, it was clearly stated that the institution, academic institution, which is at a remote place, at the rural India, are also going to be supported by Government of India if the idea is going to be highly innovative and it is going to solve the community-based problems. And we will going to have such a good mentoring support from all the peoples. Government is having a plan to having a mentoring session for such a remote institution, weak institution, so that the research and innovative components will be promoted all over the country. There is a special assessment tools going to be implemented through NEP 2020, TRECAT. The performance assessment, review and analysis of knowledge of holistic development, shortly called as TRECAT. So TRECAT, it's a national center, will be set up to assess, to set up the standards, norms, and to assess, to make the survey and to monitor the achievement, whether as per the goal it has been reached or not. Like other, we have other assessment and accreditation bodies we have, like NBA, NAC, and other accreditation bodies are there. Similarly, the TRECAT now, it is going to be the national center for setting up the norms, guidelines for assessment, even in schools as well as in college. So in all part of the educational system, this TRECAT will interfere and they will set up their norms as per the global standard, and it will be verified whether the institute achieved that particular target up to the mark, whether it is up to the mark. They are going to conduct the survey, a national level survey, achievement of survey, and this is going to be monitored through TRECAT. Coming under ranking, so there are different ranking systems of all over the world. The very renowned ranking system, we all aware that QS ranking system. So QS world ranking system is one of the renowned system which is followed, and people are very much interested as well as very much eager to be a top 10 or top 100 or even in top 500 if they come all over the world. It is a very significant achievement in their institution. So Government of India has analyzed and it has come to a conclusion that most of the Indian academic institutions should participate in this QS ranking system, and we should achieve a remarkable change in that ranking. So target is, even if it is in 100, it is a very big achievement. So QS ranking system takes 6 parameters for evaluation. First parameter is based on the academic reputation. So academic reputation in the sense, how the courses are designed, how the curriculum is framed, whether it meets the market requirement, industrial requirement, whether it is framed with industry. So many parameters are there and it gives more weightage for academic reputation. How the students are willing to take that particular university or college, how many students are applying and how many students are getting seats in the particular institution. So this is going to be a parameter which is evaluated under section academic reputation. Next is going to be the employer reputation. When a student from the particular institution joined in a particular company, how the employer gives the feedback for the particular student from that particular institution, whether it can be a university or college, what is their quality, whether they fulfill their requirements, even both physically, psychologically, mentally, technologically, how they are going to be fit for the particular company. It's going to be taken feedback from the employers, so which is going to be assessed for 10%. And next factor is faculty student ratio. So it is believed that there should be a good number of faculties to cater different students. So student faculty ratio should be in a remarkable manner, or it should be high, should be sufficient to cater all kind of students. Moreover, this NEP is going to be proposed as a multidisciplinary courses. More number of multidisciplinary courses are going to be evolved. So catering in such kind of environment, it will be a very tough task. So this faculty student ratio is also going to be an important factor which carries 20% of weightage in QS world ranking. Then next factor, the particular institution will be evaluated by the citation per faculty. So citation per faculty in the sense number of publication made by the particular faculty. So it will be calculated like total number of publications published by that particular institution to the citation cited by the citation in the sense, suppose if I am going to publish a paper, how many of the peoples have referred my paper? So this is going to be called as citation. So during their research activity, if they are going to refer my research as the literature survey, as the pre-document, and it will be cited in their published paper. So this is going to be called as citation. So this citation per faculty in the sense, how many citations are made from that particular institution, it's a ratio. Okay, citation per faculty in the sense, it's a ratio. How many citations means how many people all over the world has referred the paper published by the particular institution to the citations made by the particular faculty. So the faculty is one, if one faculty, for example, a faculty X has published a paper and this paper has been referred by 5 people, and if the institution papers are referred by 100 different scientists all over the world. So 100 divided by 5 is going to be the citation per faculty. So which will carry 20% of the weightage in QS ranking. And next is going to be the international faculty ratio. International faculty and student ratio is nothing but what all the systems are provided in the particular institution to attract the different people from all over the world, either in terms of faculty or either in terms of students. It means faculty from all over the world should show their desire to join the particular institution. Students from all over the world has to show the desire to join this particular institution, which clearly denotes the demand of this particular institution, which carries 5% so altogether 100%, and it will be evaluated. But the worry to say that in 100 rankings, we don't have any Indian institution. Slightly one by one, now it is started to enter in. When you see top universities like in QS ranking, the top universities are like Harvard University, MIT US, Stanford University, then King's College, London. So there are certain universities and colleges are showing a remarkable progress in all these criteria, giving academic flexibility to the faculties as well as for the students, even in the governance. So all this promotes the institute became getting good ranking in QS ranking. NEP 2020 also gives equal weightage to empower the faculties. It requires the faculty to show their innovative teaching, research, and their service to the best. And NEP 2020 expects the faculty to show their outstanding and creative work apart from their academic work, because government believes that this creative nature among the faculty will induct the students also. The innovative nature, the innovative critical thinking of the teachers also will initiate the or trigger the creative nature within which is present inside the students also. So this can be achieved by autonomy, good autonomy we should give for the faculty. Suppose if students come out with some innovative idea, we should support to that. And good governance in the sense like at present we all face the problem like movement of papers, files. It takes lot of time, delays in research activities and other things. So which can be stopped by some innovative technology, so that a good governance can be achieved and empowerment. It should give power to the faculties, it should give power to the students to express their innovative idea, which should express their logical and creative thinking, something which is out of the box. Because at present, the entire country has lagging in this point. Suppose if any of the students come out with some innovative or very critical idea, we used to criticize them. No, this is not possible. We used to do, because there are a lot of factors are there. Either infrastructure may not be support for that. We may not be updated to that particular extent. We may not be aware of the particular concept also. There are different factors are there, but this NEP 2020 clearly focuses on all this direction. If any students or faculty or any people come out with innovative idea, even the public, if the public who is present in and around the institution, if they come out with some new innovative idea, the institute support the public also. They have to take up the particular idea from the grassroots level, and it has to be converted into product, and it has to be converted into a commercial product, scalable manner it has to be taken up. So such kind of environment, such kind of policy has to be created in line to this NEP 2020. So it has given an equal space to creativity, innovation, and transform India to a vibrant knowledge society. As per NEP 2020, this following fields has been taken into consideration: engineering, technology, management, architecture, town planning, pharmacy, hotel management, catering technology. So these are all the prime areas which has been taken at initial stage for promotion, and lot of research activities and lot of educational reforms has to be taken in these sectors. And government has identified three important sectors where India faced the challenges in terms of healthcare, which is very important. And India lacks because of hygiene, sanitation. The next very important area where India has taken is quality education, how to impart the quality education to the students, and it has to reach all part of the country. There are different barriers are there, like different cultures, we have different territorial regions, geographically we are different. So by passing all these barriers, we have to come out with a solution, which, because right now as per NEP 2020, these three areas has been identified by Government of India, which is going to be the top-notch, with top-notch science, it has to be solved, this issues to be solved in healthcare. Affordable solution has to be reached to the all class of peoples. Right now, there are many situations are there, only the top class people can enjoy those facilities. Slow by slow, it is getting eradicated, and it can be fully eradicated only by this technology and innovations. So students, as a student, as a teacher, as a citizen of this country, we have to come out with a solution which should cater all classes of peoples, which should be the world standard, because there are two trade-off conditions are there. Once we take the quality, and we are compromising in quantity. Sometimes quantity is more and we are compromising in quality. So that never it should happen. A student or the person, a researcher, has to come out with a solution which satisfy both quantity, which should be in scalable manner, which is affordable in nature. Also, it should not compromise in terms of quality also. It has to reach the world standard, world standards. Why? Because Indian products are not reaching to the world market because of this problem, like it is not up to the world standard. So before designing, before scale up, all these factors has to be considered so that we can produce the product which satisfy the world standard, and it also going to be promote the country's revenue as well as the name. Lot of schemes has been introduced by the present government in terms of Stand-up India, Startup India. We have schemes for even in various sector. In agriculture, you have different schemes. In food processing, we have different schemes. For manufacturing, we have different schemes. So government is giving lot of benefits to promote this entrepreneurship, to make the product voice for local. So local products has been started to promote. Previously, the local products are not given any weightage. Now government is focusing, various policies has been made to promote the local products. So being the citizen of this country, we should utilize this opportunities, and we should come out with a product. Because when you see in and around you, out of 100, 90% of the products are somewhere it is imported products. You can even now you can look in and around you, 90% is 95% even starting from the pencil, rubber, or even scale, box, bag, shoe, belt, textiles, whatever the day-to-day usage, batteries or mobile, camera, whatever you take, electronic or non-electronic or mechanical item, whatever you take, 90% of the items are from other countries. It is bad to say, because in India we have a very good population, we have very good innovative ideas, we have very good creative ideas. So government feels that this creative idea, innovation, has to be taken forward, not only in terms of converting this idea into product. This product has to reach the market, not only this local market, it has to reach the global market. So as a teachers, as a student, as a citizen, everyone has to take the responsibility. We have to, because what actually, how the product can be taken up? Whenever you see any problems in and around you, the problems can be identified, and if you're going to find the solution for the problems in and around you, that is going to be the product. So this product, you have to evaluate this product in different parameters. That is very important. We are lagging in that particular. When you see the Jugaad concept, India is very famous for Jugaad concept. We can able to manage, how to manage, because without creativity and without innovation, we cannot manage those things. We are managing. When you see, even if you search in many of the search engines, Jugaad, India Jugaad, you find lot of wonders. It means that we have creativity within us, but it has to be directed in the proper direction, and it has to be taken up to the next level. So government also now started to take up this ideas, even from the school levels. When you think, even the school students, like students of class 6th to 12th, government has created CATA with a system called Atal Tinkering Lab. Because government want the ideas from the school students. 6th standard students, our ideas are taken and it has been implemented in government as a product. Many of you may be aware of this. There are many websites are there, you can go and refer. Even the class 6th students concept has been accepted by government of India as a product, as a technology. So if such a condition, we have to utilize all such kind of facilities and we have to bring this ideas, promote the creativity and innovation among the students as well as among the teachers. We should be the role model as a teacher. A teacher should be the role models for the students. And students also should discuss whatever the idea if they get, they have to discuss with their mentors. And the governance has to, the management has to provide the facility in such a way that this idea is going to be converted into a product. So that collectively, if all peoples, because government also taken various initiative, so from the grassroots level, from the starting level till the market level to industry, we can incorporate many industry peoples in this, so that they will give you the standard, what will be the standard, what will be the expectation of the industry, how you can scale up, how you can promote. So all together, we all together should join hand. And we try to transform the India to the global knowledge superpower in future. So I hope the people who are listening this video will join hands. You can also encourage others. Even if you find any people are having some creative idea and innovative idea, it should be taken up and proper credit has to be given to the particular person and it can be taken further and we can achieve a better transformation in India and globally. Thank you for this opportunity. And last announcement, next session will be on technology use in education by Mrs. Asma Rani, Assistant Professor in Computer Science Department of DBRAE. So we will be meeting in next session. Thank you for that. I'll share you, if no questions are there till question received, I'll share you one small example. In the past 2 months, in the month of July and in June and July, MHRD under Niti Aayog, they conducted a summer boot camp under Atal Tinkering Lab. So I was the mentor for 17 schools in and around Delhi, from school students from 6th to 12th. You will not believe the students who are studying at the class of 8th, 9th. Because in Atal, even you can go and search in Google, in YouTube also, there all the sessions are available. Bootcamp, Thinkpreneur, okay? You can search Thinkpreneur Bootcamp. So from 17 schools, 5 students from each school has been allocated to me. When I was going to interact with all the students, students came out very innovative ideas, like students are very much familiar in designing a game. You will not believe, students are, they written code for game. They have designed a website. They have designed the quiz. They designed the Google form. They designed the QR codings. So 23 different technologies has been taught to them. For this is a 9-week program. At last, they have to complete their assignments also. Everyone has to complete one mini project. It will be a, everyone became the entrepreneur right now. All the school students right now, because the ultimate aim of this summer boot camp is to make them an entrepreneur. So there we have teach them how to market the product, how to scale up the product, how to, because everything in digital mode we have taken. We have not taken any hardware, robotics, IoT was not taken at present. Only based on codings, it has been taken. Many students started their online stores, library, chatbot, automated chatbot. They have started to make their own chatbots, AI-based chatbots they have designed. School students, I'm telling, 6th standard, 7th standard school students has designed these codings. So such a high competitions we have, high potential we have. So this potential has to be utilized in the right direction. So all the students, as well as all the faculty, all the mentors, all the management peoples, government. So everybody should join together to promote this. Then India will become the knowledge hub. And even now we have the highest potential. That what is the big achievement of India? Because we have high, young, innovative peoples all over the world. So this mind of young minds has to be utilized in the proper direction, in the right direction. I'm not telling you anything which is beyond the things. Even you can go and search today, APL summer boot camp. You will find lot of videos, all the technologies are there. Even now you can learn all these technologies and you can be a part of that also. Any doubt to any of the students or any of the participants? The very big problem is you have different ideas, but you don't know how to express that. That is one of the very big drawback I used to find. So you have to be knowledge in the sense how you can express your idea, because that is very much important, and what really you want, because government is ready to give some support to you, but what kind of support really you want? Day and night you have to think about the concept, because when starting, everybody starts with the good potential, but day to day when it's a get progress, it get delayed. So you have to be continuously, you should work hard till you reach the target, some achievement, because at this young age, without having any commitments, you can spend good time on this creativity, so that your potential will be utilized in the right direction. So if there is no doubt, then we can wind up this today's session, and Monday by 3 o'clock we will have next session, technology use in education, by Ms. Asma Rani, Mrs. Asma Rani, Assistant Professor in Computer Science Department. Thank you so much.